Minor League Baseball is live and on the air on the show. The calendar has turned to September, and we're ready. So here's the cleanup hitter, number 15. It was a two-hit effort for him, including a home run in last night's game. And it's belted high and deep into right center. Gone!
Boy, this guy's hot right now.
Striding into the box, number 8. First at bat for him in this one. He was 1-for-4 with a double in the ballgame last night. Fly ball out toward right field. Right fielder is on the run. He gets there to make the catch, but this should bring home a run as the runner tags from third. And there. The catcher, Devin Mesoraco, stands in.
Leading off for Gwinnett, catcher, Devin Mesoraco.
And he goes the other way, but he got a lot of it. Deep down the line. And he's going to make the catch on the warning track. A fine running play there for the first out.
Time for a look at.
Play ball. Full four.
Ready to take his hacks again, number 15, as he'll look to follow up the two-run homer he launched over the wall last time up. The knee buckler, and he swings and misses at it. Set to deliver the 0-1. This is lined to left. And that's in there. Base hit. And the runner from second will stay put at third. So they're runners at the corners now with one away. Boy, there's. Ready for another shot now. Number 15. He's off to a fast start in this one. 2-for-2, including a home run. Grounded back up the middle. There's one. Relay to first in time, and just like that, the side is retired. Stepping in and ready for another shot, Jared South, as he'll look to bring home that tying run from second with a base hit into the outfield. Now the 0-2 pitch. Not fooled there as this ball's hammered out to deep right field. Gone! Guys, we've seen four big balls. Digging in, number 15. And, Dan, this could be a real make-or-break situation at this point in the game.
Yeah, Matt, at least scoring one run in this inning is so important to them to possibly get back into this thing. Baseball doesn't have a clock, but you only have 27 outs to work with. They're running out of those pretty quick.
And this is hauled in on the run as he takes quite a tumble but hangs on, and the inning is over. A final look at this tumbling catch out there in right field. Back with more Sunday Night.
Well, listen, you always want to finish strong, and they've done a real good job here, notching a win on the first day of September. They're hoping that's a sign of good things to come in this final month of the season.
11-5, the final tally in this one. The Stripers rode an important sixth inning to victory in this one. The game's futures. Luis Gohara. Digging in, number 15. It was a two-hit effort for him, including a home run in last night's game. Here's the first pitch to him. And a pitch out, nothing doing, though, and that's ball one. That one's going to find the seats, strike one. Dan, D-Row, we take a look at our home nine as they take the field here today. Well, they come in fresh off a victory last time out, but they've had a rough go of it of late as they've lost 7 of their last 9 games.
Hey, Matty V, you know, if there's such a good thing as splitting a series, D-Row, this is the one. They lose the first 2 games of this series, win game 3. They'd like nothing more than to split.
At the plate, number 15, batting from the right side with the southpaw on the mound.
This game is rolling right along as we move into the middle innings. with no score. You'd think by now one of these two teams would be able to get some big.
Hello.
Now with the late number 15. One for two with a double on the ledger so far.
Hi, Richard.
First pitch of the at-bat. Strike one to start the at-bat. Now a ball grounded to short. This could be two. To second for one. On to first as they get the double play to get him out of the inning. Now batting, number 15. He'll hit from the right side of the batter's box against the left-handed pitcher. Hot shot toward third, but quick reactions at the hot corner take away a hit, and they're... Stepping up now, Sean Cardona.
Leading off for the striper, second baseman.
It in the air toward the line and right. Right fielder is on the run, one down.
Play ball.
A single run good enough to do it today. 1-0 the final score. Will Combs.
I love your videos.
Thank you, Richard.
Time for baseball. Carlo Garcia gets the call to pitch here on opening day in front of the hometown crowd. Dan Plesac, what's the word on him?
Hey, we're looking at a guy that knows how to pitch. Last year, his ERA...
There's a swing and a drive hit well out to right field, and that is off the wall. He takes the turn and heads for second. And he will coast into second with a leadoff double. Into the box now, number 12. He readies for his first plate appearance.
Number 12.
He's ready. Here's the first offering. Now a shot out toward the alley in right center. Around first, he's digging for second. And he'll pull into second here with nobody out.
Let's take another look at just a textbook swing right there. Good weight.
Into the box, number 12. He scored a run after stroking a double in his first at-bat. First pitch coming, here it is. Hit on the ground down the first baseline. A dive, and oh, he can't hang on. And the effort pays off as he's able to recover and get the second out. Stepping in, A.J. Reed. He got on top of one and was a ground-out victim last time. Pulled high in the air out to right field. Long run for the right fielder. Uh-oh, he whiffs on it. But he can't get there, and it bounces over the wall. It's a ground rule double.
Yeah, looked like an easy play from where I'm sitting, but I think he took it for granted and basically whiffs on the darn thing, allowing the runner to move to second on a two.
So striding in, number 12. One for two with a double on his line thus far. And they pitch out here, but nothing's going on. The 1-0. Pulled toward right center field. May sprinting after it. He makes the catch. What a play on the run to end the inning. So no runs. And Charlie Tilson now comes forward. He doubled earlier in the game, one for two to this point. Now the 2-1 pitch. Pulls this one into the air out into right field. Waiting on it, the right fielder, two gone. So the lineup flips over and digging in, Victor Zavala. He singled his last time up. Lifted in the air out to right. Under it is the right fielder, and he brings it in for the second out of the inning.
Play ball. Three.
Ready once again, number 12. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. This is on the ground over to first. Reed picks it up. A flip to the pitcher covering, and that will retire the side. So no runs, no hits, no errors, and no one left. Not too many more shots left. Home half of the eighth coming up. The Bulls lead it 3-0. Standing in, number 20. Last time through was a base hit. From the stretch. Popped him up. Number 35. Backs up a bit and he takes charge for the first out.
Play ball.
Three to two, the finish in tonight's game. The Durham Bulls took the lead in the second inning and rode that until the very end.
I'm going to sim to, like, the end last game because I want to sign with the Tampa Bay Rays.
Manager checks in with his ball club. This coach wants his players ready to rise to the challenge of clutch moments. This manager appeals to his hitters to be more discerning at the plate. A player receives the check-in from one of his coaches. An agent checks in with a client currently in the minors. Clutch hitting has not been a strength for this team, and their manager lets them know it. A manager checks in with his ball club. A player is confronted with a less than stellar stat. This minor league team is reminded that the eyes of the organization are keeping tabs on them. Player receives a check-in from one of his coaches. A manager checks in with his ball club. Presses a player to keep raising the bar on the development of his signature skills. This minor league team is reminded that the eyes of the organization are keeping. a lost season is never fully lost, because any situation can be a teaching opportunity. With the team's chances hanging by a thread, this skipper calls for a last stand.
Triple-A baseball for you now on the show as we standing in number 12 carries a batting line in the 280s to begin this one. Ready with the first pitch, here it comes. Line hard to the left side, but this is a foul ball. Dan Dero, we take a look at our home nine as they take the field here today. They continue to fall on hard times, losing again last time out, and that makes seven losses in their last eight games.
Yeah, Matty V, and you know what, Dero, this is when you really get tested. They call it the dog days of August for a reason. When you're struggling like this team is right now, the games get long, the schedule gets long, and you start looking forward towards the end of the season.
Yeah, but you got to find a way, Dan. You know as well as I do. You got to look in the mirror. You're playing for way more, especially the way this team is underachieved. You got to keep grinding. You got to find a way to put your foot on the gas and show up to the yard every day ready to go.
Digging in for his second at bat, number 12, batting from the right side with the southpaw on the mound. He's ready. Here's the first offering. Ground ball sent back up the middle. He gets dirty, but he can't get there, and it's into center field. One run is scored, and they won't come close to getting him. He's in there at third.
The pitcher got the result.
Now at the plate, Manny Guillen. The average for him entering play sits down in the 250s. Fly ball out toward right field. Right fielder giving chase. Makes the catch, and that'll retire the side. So they're held in check here. This
leading up for the
now the payoff pitch home.
Center fielder.
Hit in the air to right field. Right fielder has a beat on it. One out.
Play ball.
Now in the box, C.J. Baxter, as he'll get his first opportunity in this one.
C.J. Baxter.
In the air out toward right field. Number 12 is going to have room out there as he puts this away to retire the side. Stepping up to the plate, number 12. Two men on, two away here in the fourth. Here's the first pitch to him. Now this is driven out to deep right center. This could be trouble. And trouble it is. It's down for extra bases. And to score is the runner from first. It's 7-0.
Man, if I was on the mound, I would not let this guy hurt me. He's been...
trying to pick things up where he left off. Number 12. He's got three hits, including a double to this point. He's ready. Here's the first offering. Smoked on the ground up the middle. The second for one. Relay to first in time. And just like that, the second. Digging in the switch hitter, number 12. He was a double play victim last time around. Now a drive out to left center field. They'll add on to their total as the run scores all the way from first. It's a 10-0 score. Striding in once again, Tom Sanchez. He looked to bounce back after striking out his last time up. high and deep to right. Looking up is the right fielder, still going back. And goodbye, this one ain't coming back. Digging in and looking for more, number 12, runner in scoring position with Sugan. Here comes the first pitch. Hit down the line at first. This is foul for the first strike. Nunez at second with two down. On its way, the 0-2 pitch. A swing and a drive sent out toward the gap. And trouble it is. It's down for extra bases. Hack on another here as the runner scores from second. And he will pull into second with an RBI double. Austin Hayes the next to bat. It was a flyout for him in his last trip.
Austin Hayes.
Now a swing and he pops him up. And this should do it. Number 35 is there. Makes the catch and the ball game is over. 13-2 is the rather one-sided final tally. Durham jumped out to an early lead in the first and never looked back. Eric Sammons earns his eighth victory. Welcome to MLB. Digging in now, number 12. He'll get his first shot with the bat here.
Number 12.
Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. And a pitch out. Nothing doing, though, and that's ball one. Ham leads off first with one away. And they pitch out here, but nothing's happening. Ball two. Ready with the 2-0 pitch. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Engel is there to put it away, and the runner will be forced to retreat back to first.
Fly ball. Defense!
7-5, tonight's final. The Durham Bulls rode an important sixth inning to victory in this one. Xavier Bernard claimed. Minor League Baseball at the plate, number 12. Couple of hits for him in four trips to the plate last night. Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. This is lined to left, and that'll get down for a base hit. Now a long throw to third. Throw won't get him. Nothing to score tonight. Charlotte took the lead in the second inning and rode that until the very end. Taylor Roderick earns his first win of the season.
Manager checks in with his ball club. player is encouraged to continue to refine a skill essential to his game. This manager appeals to his hitters to be more discerning at the plate. A player receives a check-in from one of his coaches. An agent checks in with a client currently in the minors. Manager checks in with his ball club. A player receives a check-in from one of his coaches. A manager checks in with his ball club. Thank you. This minor league team is reminded that the eyes of the organization are keeping tabs on them. This hitting coach is looking to get more out of one of his sluggers. With the season approaching its final stretch, a manager calls for heightened focus from his players. The player receives a check-in from one of his coaches. This minor league team is reminded that the eyes of the organization are keeping tabs. A young team gets some extra coaching up from their skipper before the first game of a very big series. With the team's chances hanging by a thread, this skipper calls for a last stand.